confused the eyebrows. So I've been sick, as you guys saw from my videos. If you didn't watch my YouTube shorts, then I don't know what you're doing. But you would know from my videos, I've been sick. So I couldn't go get my eyebrows done. I'm sad. But we're going to be doing a twist out today because it's 12 o'clock at night. I'm not doing a wash and go. I'm going to be using this Thank God It's Natural Green Tea Super Moist Leave-In Conditioner. It's my first time using it. Has green tea, argan oil, lightweight moisturizing leave-in conditioner for all types. It smells mad good. Like, I don't even know how to explain it. It just smells so pretty. I'm gonna be trying this Taraji P Twist and Set Moisture Rich Twisting Cream. It defines, hydrates, and elongates for curly and coil. We'll see. This smells good, but it's not up my alley. So these are gonna be the two products that I use together, a leave-in conditioner and a twisting curling cream. And then if I feel like I need a little bit of extra hold to kind of give me that definition I'm gonna be looking for, I'm gonna go in with my extreme gel. And then I'm gonna be using my brush. I'm on the look for a detangling brush. I know everybody uses the Unbrush, but I just feel like I'm not gonna like it. I just cannot fathom that that brush works in every hair type, from the silkiest of the silkiest hair. I've seen the silkiest and people not of color use that brush and say it's amazing, to the people of color with the most dense, coarse, nappy head. Not in a bad way, but nappy head, use it in the hair and say it works. It's just no way that it just works across all hair types. And I'm just someone that doesn't like to throw away my money. So I haven't jumped on the Unbrush wave yet, and I don't know if I will. The detangling teaser in Target that a lot of naturals talk about, but I felt the bristles and it's a little too soft. Like, I just feel like it's not gonna go through my hair. But yeah, I'm on the hunt for a brush. So if anybody knows a good detangling brush, comment below. So back to the video. So I had this over my head. Ooh, all the water. Somebody broke my spray bottle, so now I don't have one. And I was trying to keep the moisture in my hair because I don't have anything to spray my hair with, and it's annoying to like keep dipping my hands in the sink and dipping with the brush. So I'm gonna actually put that cap back on my head. I'm just separating my hair down the middle. I'm gonna start on this side because I have more hair on this side. It's gonna take me longer. I feel like when you do a twist out, it's okay if your hair starts to dry, but it makes it harder to comb out. So I'd rather it be wet than dry. And then me having to go back and wet it a little bit, more work at the front of my head, because it doesn't really matter. I usually like to start from back to front, but we'll start front to back today. Switch it up a little bit. So we're just separating the hair. I'm going with the leave-in conditioner first. I'm so excited. This stuff smells so good. So it's nice and thick. I put that much. That seems about right for this section. We're just gonna massage it in. So I'm gonna take this section again. And this is where I just start splitting it. So this would be one twist here. I'm gonna go ahead, start from, what is this called? Your ends to your roots. I'm so tired, it's 12 o'clock at night. Give it a nice comb out. Go in with the Taraji P Twist and Set. This stuff is pretty thick too. So I feel like that's an appropriate amount for this part. Okay, this is with the products right through my hair. Am I showing it? Okay. Oh, good. Okay. This is what it looks like. Then I just take it and twist on down. And you want to keep it as smooth as possible when you're twisting it down, because you'll get the best results that way. Always when I get to the bottom, I always comb it out. And even though this is not so much of a, this isn't a lot of hair, but because it's so wide, I need my root to lay as flat as possible. So I am going to split it in half because the twist would have been fine in itself, but my root would have been super puffy. So that's why I break it up into very small sections the way that I do, because I don't want my roots to be super puffy. This is why I prefer a twist out, because it's just so much more relaxing than sitting here and stressing about a wash and go and wetting my hair. That looks so good. Yo, this twist out's about to come out bomb. I've been kind of tired of doing my hair, so I was actually gonna put it into a protective hairstyle, and I was gonna go with knotless boho braids, because I've never had boho box braids. I've always just had regular box braids because they're so expensive. But now that my sister knows how to do it, she did my niece's hair and it looked so good. So I was like, oh, I've been wanting to do the mini twist, but I kind of was waiting until it got hot in like summer to do that, when I'm like in the pool every single day and stuff like that. Cause I feel like getting in the pool every day with box braids is annoying. Did I put this in my hair already? I can't tell. A little extra moisturizer won't hurt. So I haven't been talking too much. See, look at that. Top half of my head's almost done. If I was doing a wash and go, I probably would have still been at the bottom here. I'm actually gonna probably have to sit underneath the dryer tonight so that my hair could dry. I typically don't do that. I usually let it air dry, but that's just because I'll walk around with twists in my hair for a couple days, like a day or two before I take them out. But today is Saturday, technically Sunday, because it's after 12 o'clock. And I have church in the morning, and I don't want to go to church with mini twists in my hair. Okay, so you guys see the issue here? If you leave it like that, your twist out is not gonna come out good. I'd rather just have to go back and retwist it. It could just be because like you didn't twist tight enough, and so you left a gap there while you were twisting. So just always go back, don't be lazy. Moving on to the back of my head, which you cannot see. So I'll come back on camera, I guess, when I get to this side, to the front of my head. Yeah. So I'm done with this half of my head. I'm done. And y'all, it took me 20 minutes to finish the rest of my head. So I did this part in front with you guys, and then the back. Are you kidding me? If I was doing a wash and go, I wouldn't have even been done with half my head in 20 minutes. I don't know. Might have to give up the wash and goes for a little while, because they'd be taking too long. This was like perfect. I wanted to come back on camera and talk about this. Leave-in conditioner. First of all, it says nothing on here about being a detangler, but it detangles my hair so well. I'm in shock, and my hair feels so soft. Like, it is moisturizing the mess out of my hair. Like, my hair feels so moisturized. Like, I feel like I could just do my twist out with just this. I don't even need this. But this is doing good too. This is actually some good stuff. These products are both good. So, and this part is super moisturizing and like hydrating. So I'm excited. My hair feels good. I wish you guys can come to the camera and just like go like this. It feels so good. This stuff right here is about to be my new favorite leave-in conditioner. Usually my go-to leave-in conditioner when I do a twist out is the Cantu. Seems like a lot, but this is also a lot. So, but yeah, this might be my new go-to leave-in conditioner. I absolutely love it. It makes my hair feel so good. I can't wait to get a curl cut, or do they call it the diva cut? The cut where it's like it gets shorter. I don't want layers, but I want it to be like frame my face. And you need very little of this. A little of this goes a long way. So the bottle may seem like a small bottle, but you don't need a lot in your hair at all. I'm telling you, you don't need a lot. Look at that. Oh my god, look how it just defined my curls. Like, look at that. This stuff right here, go get you some. And I'm so excited about my twist out tomorrow, you guys. Like, so excited. That is very uneven. That's another thing. You don't want your pieces to be uneven because it will, you will see the difference in your wash and go. Like this side needed a little bit more hair. It like that all makes a difference. You'd be surprised like how you portion out the two strands of twist and bringing them down. I'm feeling it. And as I'm twisting, another thing is like when I'm twisting it, I'm kind of smoothing down and I'm feeling the hair. And when you start to feel like it's a little knotted and tangled, go in and you just brush it. And then keep it moving. Now it's a lot smoother. Beautiful. I might use this product when I do my mini twist. And then another trick. Oh, is this where my postpartum is happening? Yeah. So I've been trying to figure out where my hair is falling out at. So I'm going through postpartum shedding still. It was really bad. So my daughter's 9 months now. No, she's still 8 months. She's 8 months. And I've been trying to figure out where the heck is my hair coming out at because I don't see it. I had my husband look through my head like, do you see a bald spot? Like, and I think it's happening at the front of my hair because I don't typically have thinner edges. And then I don't know, it's hard to say because like look how much shorter this is like compared to the rest of my hair. Like I think that's where it's breaking. I think it's happening at the front of my head because this is looking a little empty over here. It's been devastating, you guys. I have never experienced hair loss. Even with my first kid, I didn't have hair loss. And I should have expected it though, because thinning is like hereditary in my family. Like we all in our prime have like this super thick, beautiful hair. And then like now that my mom's getting older, my aunts are older, their hair is a lot thinner than what it was when they were my age. So it's just a hereditary thing as well. So I just have to brace myself for my hair to be really thin when I get older. I don't think anything I do is gonna stop it. Embrace the thickness now and try not to complain about it because when I hit my 40s and my 50s, my hair, I'm gonna have half the hair on my head than what I have now. I can't even talk right. Look, I did it again. You do not want your twist to be like that because it will not come out good. Yo, y'all, my daughter will not sleep. I don't know what's wrong. I've thought about taking her to the doctor, but I feel like my doctor, which is so cool, quick, really quick. My daughter's pediatrician was my pediatrician. Love him. He would probably laugh at me and he'd be like, you're really bringing her here because she doesn't sleep, she's a baby. And I'm like, no, you don't understand. She does not nap throughout the day. So it's not like we're giving her too many naps throughout the day. And when she does nap throughout the day, it's no more than an hour. She will not sleep past an hour. So then when it comes down to nighttime, you guys, I'm telling you, I've tried everything. I had the method of letting her cry. So we did the 5-10-15 method. And it works sometimes. But we feel bad. The poor girl's crying so much, she's choking. So we let her cry, but for so long. We time her bottles so that way she gets her bottle at a certain time of the night. She is teething, but we bought the numbing gel. That worked for like 3 days, maybe 4 days, and then it hasn't worked ever since. She doesn't like teething toys that are cold. She won't chew on them. Like, I have the most difficult 8-month-year-old, and we're just out of options. And we've tried the sound machine. The sound machine worked for like a solid couple of months, and it doesn't work anymore. Rock her to sleep, that's not enough. So the last thing that I'm gonna try that I can only, the only thing I can think of is getting her the weighted sleep sack. Maybe that'll help her, but I don't know because she doesn't even like to wear onesies at night. So I, as in like footy pajamas, she doesn't like anything with her feet closed in. So I don't think she's gonna like the weighted sleep sack. I think she's gonna cry to have it off, and those things are expensive. So yeah, we just don't even know what to do with her anymore. So if anybody has any like natural remedies that'll knock a baby out, please tell me, because sis don't sleep. She goes to sleep crying, she wakes up crying. Just have a difficult baby. My firstborn was not like this. She was a dream. She was amazing. And that's why I was excited to have another one, because I'm like, oh, if she's anything like my first, this is going to be the best. And of course, this baby is like giving us a run for our money. We're like, we think we're done. Yeah, we're like, that's how bad it is. We're like, me and my husband joke around all the time. We're like, yeah, we're done. That's it. No more kids. She ruined it for all the other kids coming forward. So we don't even know if we want any more kids. That's how bad it is. And then like she's very clingy. I don't know if it's just because like I'm a stay-at-home mom, so I'm home with her all the time, but I make sure that I don't hold her all day. So it's not like I'm holding her all day. She's either in her crib, she's either in her seat while I'm in the kitchen cooking, or she's eating. I put her on the floor, she crawls around and plays. So like I don't know where she gets this like clinginess from, where she always, somebody always has to be holding her. And oh my god, god forbid you walk out of the room for 5 minutes, the girl's screaming on top of her lungs if you walk out of the room. So yeah, I don't know what's going on with her. I really don't know, but we gotta do something because we ain't getting no sleep. Oh, you know what I didn't try either? That cherry juice that people give their kids, the cherry tart juice. I'm gonna try that to give and maybe give her a little bit of that at night. Maybe that'll help. I don't know how much that stuff helps or what the science is behind it that makes you want to go to sleep, but we're gonna try it out. I'm willing to try anything since your girl is struggling. I cry all the time. I'm like, I just want to get some sleep. And because she doesn't have a solid sleep schedule, I don't have a solid sleep schedule, so I'm just tired all the time. Because sometimes I go to bed at night, sometimes I'm up till 3-4 in the morning with her. Like, it is terrible. It has been terrible. I can't wait for her to get out of this like this stage of whatever she's in, because I need my sleep. I'm someone where if I don't get my sleep, I am so cranky all day. Like, I'm just not a pleasant person to be around if I don't get enough sleep. If I don't get no sleep, and if I don't have no food in my system, don't talk to me. So I'm doing the back, and then I'll come back on camera. Guys, so, wow, why haven't I done this sooner? I'm not even gonna talk about it. Oh, wait, I don't like this light. It's the lighting. There we go. Here's officially done. This is what it looks like. If you get close. Decide if I'm gonna sit underneath the dryer or not. I really don't feel like it. I'm just gonna throw my bonnet over my head, but because I'm not going to bed right away, I'm gonna let my hair sit out a little bit and air dry because it is still very wet. All right, y'all, I'm back. I still have my twist in my hair. I twisted my hair Sunday and it is now Friday. It's been 5 days, but in my defense, I got sick again, and I was sick because I went to the doctor. I don't normally go to the doctor when I get sick. I'm not one of those. I just kind of like drink some tea, get some rest, take some vitamins. But other than that, I was sick. So, and my eyebrows weren't done. So I needed to rejuvenate and put on our fingers. I'm excited. I need a scrunchie. Okay, so when we're taking them out, we're just gonna go the opposite way. Like this. We kind of let them untwist on their own. And boom. And then I like to separate them as I go. I don't like to go back in and have to separate. I do it as I'm separating. So I only separate them twice where they naturally separate. Boom. And then I'm gonna do that throughout my whole head. I twist, y'all. Look at that. Look at that definition. Definition like this, but look, I don't need a challenge. final result. It came out so cute. I always prefer like day 2 and 3 of a twist out, but this is really cute. Right now I'm just going in, and because I lost my pick and I never went and got a new one, so I'm using the widest tooth comb I could find. And I'm just fluffing it out. I'm getting rid of the part back here. You guys, thank you so much for watching. Make sure you guys like, comment, and subscribe, and all the products that I use in this video will be linked below in my description box. And yeah, make sure you guys stay tuned in for my next video.